Hi everyone, this is Aki with another keynote video. We're going to go over possible solution to a situation when you have to resize your already made presentation. So I have a presentation here, you know, the document size, you can double check what it is. If you go to the top of your menu and you go scroll down to slide size, you have a widescreen 16:9. That's my presentation size right now. Now that these are the proportions for your slide, but that's not necessarily the resolution. If you click on the custom slide size, it will tell you what's the resolution. Now, 1920x1080, that's one 16:9 resolution. You can also have, I have a cheat sheet here, 1600x900 and so on. So you wanna know the resolution as well as the proportions. Number one, resize your slides in document size. Now, if I click standard size right now, so proportion 4:3, because let's say I find out I have to actually present it on a screen that's that size and I need to resize my presentation. Now you can see it's showing up off a bit, like I have that white space above and below and so on, and so it's not perfect. However, one good thing about this way of going about, you know, changing your slide size is that all the animations are still there. You would have to still manually fix some things, like you can see things are off. However, in animations and transitions and so on, it's still intact, and that's a lot of work, so that's really helpful. Now if I go back and click, okay, I don't want to do this because this seems a lot of work, I'm going to click widescreen. Look what happens, it's actually changing now the standard size presentation to widescreen. So this is even more off now, and you're like, panic, don't panic. You just click Command Z before you save, because once you save, you won't be able to use the Command Z. So number one thing before I even do anything is make copy of my presentation. So I have two presentation, one in standard size and one in widescreen, and we're going to work with the copy. So then whatever I mess up, it's all good because I have a copy of the originals. Number two, copy and paste your slide size. So I found this as a suggestion in a number of places, and I wanna show you what happens. So, you know, I have a presentation here that's widescreen, and I'm going to open one that I created a standard presentation. Now, remember how we were talking about the standard size, even though the proportions of the document are 4:3, I do want to see what's the custom slide size, and I'm going to increase it to actually 1600x1200 to make it still proportionally 4:3. However, the proportions are, the resolution is higher. And so the suggestion has been to copy you know, everything on your slide. So let's say I'm going to copy everything on here and go to my new presentation as a different presentation, go to slide one and paste. And obviously I can see right away this is still not working, and now I can't, if I start moving things, you would have to first try to group it. If I select everything and go to format, arrange and group, and now I try to resize, it's, some things are resizing but not all, like the page number is not resizing, this title is not resizing, so it's not ideal. I mean, you can still try to resize individually things and so on. Now one benefit of this option is that actually my animations are still there, so I wouldn't have to like redo all of that. So that's something to consider. So, you know, you can maybe for some items you might want to copy and paste. Now if I copy a slide, not just the items on a slide, but let's say here I'm going to select the slide and click Command C, copy, go to my standard presentation and then paste the slide. What's one good thing is actually that, let me just move that, change the order, I see in the bottom right corner of the slide that actually my transition copied as well. And I know that when I go to animate, I can see that magic move is being used here. So not only, you know, the things on my slide are copied, but really what am I doing? What am I doing is basically is just resizing it and moving individual slides. So to me, this solution is really not better than if I just go to my widescreen presentation and just go to document and resize it here. So I don't think that's necessarily like a good solution for resizing presentations. Number three, copy to preview application. So I have a slide here. I'm going to select everything on the slide, click copy. Now you want to go to your preview application and go to file, new from clipboard. And now what it does, it's basically creating an image from everything you copied from the slide. And now I can just go command A, copy, and go to my standard presentation, go to a new slide and click paste. Okay, this looks all great. However, this is an image, so there is no animation, and I still see that some items, you know, are an issue, so maybe I would have to manually change things. This could be a solution for some things on your presentation. Let's say I have a graphic here, and if I select all the items that I created in my graphic, and I went to my preview, new from clipboard, file, new from clipboard, and I have actually my image right here that I can paste in my standard presentation now. So let me go back to a new slide. Okay, this looks great. Now, the issue can be, because this is an image, you have to be aware of pixelation, because if you coming from smaller size presentation with fewer pixels and you're trying to create a higher pixeled presentation, then this can be blurry. Now, another issue is that this obviously is just an image. So if I go to my widescreen presentation, if I play, this is actually animated graphics, so I'm losing all of this interesting and fun animation that I have created. So this is really not solving your issue, and maybe for some items you might do that, you might even do that for within the presentation, but I don't think this is better than the first solution, which is manually just changing that document slide size. So this is really not the best option. Number four, make a movie. So another suggestion that I found was kind of interesting. It was basically creating a movie from your current presentation and pasting it into the new size presentation. So let's say I'm going to take a couple of slides, because otherwise it's just going to take too much space. And I'm going to, let's do some slides from slide 10 to maybe 13. And I'm going to export this. And I'm going to export this here. And now I'm going to go to my new standard presentation and paste the new movie and see how this works and whether it will solve our problems. So I'm going to my standard presentation, go to a new slide, and I'm going to drag the new movie that I created there, right there. So you can copy, it just tells me it's not going to play on iPhone or iPad, it's fine. Okay, now I can see that I can either resize it or try to change some things, but I'm going to play it. Okay, so I can see that, you know, my animations are there, so that's fine. So I didn't lose my animation. However, you know, I can still see the white space here and the issues with the slide number, so I will show you the one fix for that. I would have to probably remove this and then add slide numbers to my standard presentation. Just going to format slide number, and then I have the slide number. So I would remove it from the original one, and so then I can add my own slide numbers to the new one. However, this really didn't fix much, and it's just a movie playing in the different size presentation. So I really don't like this suggestion that much. Maybe for some items, like some complex graphics that you have created, you may want to use that as a shortcut. But I don't think this is a good solution for most presentations. Number five, best practices for manual slide size change. So the first the first solution that we talked about is the manual change. So if we just change it here in document size, but we you know, saw the issues with it. So I want to show you a couple of best practices to put in place before you even change your slide size. Number one is if you're trying to group items on your, so right now I can see that this image, if I go to animation, there's an animation involved. And if I go to build order, I can see some animations being done on this item. If I select all of the items on my slide, and if I go to format, arrange, and group it, and you know, then you're resizing things, then guess what? If I click this item now this is one combined item, there is no animation, so you will lose animation. If I now ungroup it, if I go to format, ungroup, and I go to my item, the animation is gone. So be aware that if you're grouping items that have animations, you will lose them. So in that case, some things you might want to group, but not others. Number two, working with text. So the text, the way you have it set up, like, let me show you what I mean. So I have this title and some text here. And if I try to group it, to resize it, I don't have the group option. However, if I'm going to make a copy of this slide, and I'm going to change the color of the background, and now I'm going to make a copy of this text and delete the original, and I'm going to move this back, I can see that if I go to format, arrange, group, I can group the text. So you can group text if the text that you have in your slide is not part of the theme. So right now, if you go to your edit slide layout, this will be like your layout for your document. And this is where, if you're using any of these layouts and you, let's say, if I'm going to add slide, and I'm going to put this, and here I'm going to say title, subtitle, some text. If I'm using the theme sections, if I select this, I cannot group, but if I do copy, paste, I can group it. So that's an interesting thing that when I found out, I was like, okay, that made no sense, but that does affect the situation. Like, I'm going to take out the slide where you wanna, you know, change text for multiple sections. Like if you wanna group it and reposition or expand it. Number three best practice is if you have your text, you want to make sure that if you go to style, so if you go to format, text, and layout, you want to check that shrink text to fit. If I have this unchecked, if I'm going to now group this text is not changing. It's just either I can see it or not, depending on the box. So I don't want that. If I go to, you know, if I select this, I have to ungroup it first. Go to format, text, layout, and shrink text to fit. And if I group it now, if I'm changing it, I can resize it this way. So I can resize all at the same time. However, you can see that it doesn't resize, it doesn't become bigger, but it just becomes smaller. Because the way you want to set up your text, if I ungroup it right now, you have to put some maximum size for your text. So my text, if I go to format, text, style, I'm going to say the title be 250 and the text maximum be 200. So now if I'm going to group this, I'm going to be able to resize it much larger. So it's much easier this way. So this is the way to kind of set up and help yourself resize things if you have multiple text boxes and sections on your slide. Finally, the number four best practice is your slide pages. So if I, you know, I have a page right here, and if I change my document now, I'm going to change it manually to standard. You can see that the slide, the page slide number, it's like off. And if I go to format, uncheck this and try to put it back, still there. So let's maybe go back before we resize it. So if this is the original, and I'm going to uncheck the slide number, and now I'm going to go to document, change it to standard, and now I'm going to add the slide number. It's still in that place. The reason why, because the slide number, it's part of the theme where it was set up. So you actually would have to put a new page number in your new presentation that's now in the standard format in new place, and you can just edit slide layout and position it somewhere else. So you would have to create like a page number on the new layout, have to kind of do it on all the section of your theme where, let's say, I think I was using blank. Let me see. Blank. Let me see, where's the slide number? Done. Yep, now it works. So you have to kind of know which section of the theme you were doing, but that's the way to kind of fix the slide number if you are using it in your new presentation. So hopefully this helped you understand how, you know, you would have to make some changes to your new presentation. Although it's not ideal, it doesn't solve everything. It's not a quick one-click solution. There's some best practices you can put in place to make the transition much easier. So thanks so much for watching.